Hi guys, Luku is here. This is Revy Ruby and welcome back to my channel. Like looking back on that video, guys. This week I wanna try and make a video right now because I feel like it's 4 o'clock here and in the Emirates and the sun is almost going down and I'm using my natural light. So let me try to make this video. And guys, remember I announced to you guys that I'm gonna be having a 3,000 subscribers giveaway. Now we are almost at 3.6. We have a couple of them to go 4,000. So before I continue go with this video, let me guys show you one of the t-shirts that I did that I want to give away. Like one of the printouts are these ones. I printed out t-shirts in Bangkok. I bought a couple of t-shirts in Bangkok and printed them away, and this is one of them. It's written begin again. I'm just gonna stand and show you guys. Yeah, you can stretch it. It fits all, I think. Yeah, it just fits all, and you know, it's one size fits all. It's medium. Usually I'm small, but I am fitting all to this. So guys, I'm gonna show you a couple of them. So yeah, one of them is that. So a couple of colors. I have these colors, the blue, the purple, the orange, dark orange, and then I have this one also, gray. And I also have another one. It's written, success starts with self-discipline. And also this one. I love this color as well. Yeah. So I printed a couple of them, guys. And this is for you guys, for like whoever wants. I don't know how I'm going to give them away, but just like randomly let me know on the comment below if you like. I think you have to DM me. Follow me on Instagram and then DM me your address on how I can send it to you. And then I'm gonna pick a random. There are how many t-shirts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Today I only have 6 t-shirts, guys. Sorry for that. But for whoever is going to be, you know, I am going to like, if you guys like them, let me see, what am I doing? Yeah, I'm going to print more and send more to more of my subscribers, but for now I'm gonna do just 6. So let me know exactly. I can only afford these ones for now, but you know, it is what it is. So yes guys, so today, as you can see by the title of the video, I want to shout out to one of my subscribers. Her name is Sarah Ahmed. She's very loyal. She's very diligent. Not that all of you are not loyal, guys. Everyone is loyal in my channel and everyone is showing me so much support. But she's always like very, like she's always been like the way, the kind of messages she actually, lots of messages of encouragement, guys. All of you are writing me a lot of messages of encouragement, but mostly her, she's just like, really like the way she talk. I feel like she is like, a sister, you know. So she's like very encouraging. I hope you guys like my backdrop today. You know, I have a little bit of a thingy going on there. So yeah, I hope you guys like it. But anyway guys, let me start this video now. And according to the what is it called? Okay guys, sorry, before I continue with this video, let me stop ranting and rambling and getting out of topic before I bore you guys to death. Let's just say that please guys, continue sharing my videos and also subbing and also giving it a thumbs up. And even if you somebody people usually, there's no video on YouTube that doesn't have a thumbs down. But for me, in my video, if I get a thumb down, you know how I think of it. I think of it that you like my video so much that you have chosen to download it. Like when you press a thumbs down, to me, it's a download. You are downloading. You like my video that much. But anyway, guys,
just to let you know, if you like it, thumbs up. Please subscribe before you continue. I'm not gonna bore you anymore. Let's start this video. And by the title you've seen, I'm going to attempt a topic. It is regarding if do Arab men actually, the marriages between Arab men and Western people, do they even marry Western people, and do their marriages actually last? So I'm going to make an attempt to answer this based on a couple of research that I did, and I went and I read a couple of blogs and online, and a couple of women who are Western women who are married to Arab men were actually had a forum, and they were all talking about their experiences in marrying Arab men. And do Arab men, and today you have to know that there are couple, when we are gonna talk in this topic, you have to actually know that there are different types of Arab men. We have Muslim Arabs, and we also have even Christian Arab men. We have even atheist, we have agnostic, we have Orthodox, we have very different types of Arab men. And today I'm specifically just going to speak about Muslim Arabs. And I am not going to bash any religion over here. We are not going to do that. And I apologize if maybe some of the things I talk about might make you feel a bit offended in a way, but I am not here to, I don't have an intention of even offending anybody. So we are going to talk about Muslim Arabs, and if they marry out, like they marry, you know, like Westerners, based on this blog post that I have read. And actually, yes, they do. And in most cases, let's start with the Arab. Mostly now, the ones I'm gonna talk about are the ones who are whom like, let's say, Emirati Arabs. In most cases, they are very traditional and they really don't marry out in most cases. But in some cases, they are some Arabs who are actually studied outside the US, outside the country, and they are more open-minded, and their families are also quite open to having them date and marry whoever they want or whoever they choose to. So in most cases, in some cases, yes, it does happen, but usually they stick to their own. They marry their own, you know. And yes, let's start with the Arab woman. She can marry a Western man if of her choice, and there is nowhere in the law that prohibits her from marrying a Western person. The only thing that I know is that she is her children that she will bore with, she will give birth to children with the Western guy. The children will not be citizens the Emirates. The children will not get citizenship. Like, I think they will have to go through, they will get government support. They will get most, you know, the things that the benefits that most children who are born here get. But in some cases, they will not get citizenship. The citizenship is only, they will only get from their father's side, you know, if it is a British or whatever citizen, the children will get from there, but they will not get the Emirates citizenship. It's only left for the children who are born from the Emirates, both Emirates parent, Emirati parents, if that makes sense. Yes. So in most cases, she will marry, I'm trying to make the, is it recording 8 minutes already? Oh my God. In most cases, an Emirati woman will marry, Emirati Muslim woman will marry a Western man, but only on one exemption. He has to actually convert to be a Muslim for this girl, the woman, to marry this man. And you know, some of the Western men are so in love with these women, and you know, because of their traditional way and how conservative and very like extremely traditional and very like reserved, and very their sexual purity and just the way they are as women, respecting themselves and everything. So sometimes some Western men are very you know, and also family orientated, and they are very like homemakers, you know. And most of these Westerners are attracted to this, so they get this, they marry these women, but these women will only accept them if actually they are obviously accepting to denounce their religion to become a Muslim. And let's say the man comes to live here. Obviously, it's not difficult for the man to find a job here, especially the Western men, because it's according to your passport. You get a job easily, and the post you get paid much higher than the people from different countries like Bangladesh. You know, like the low, like I wouldn't say low class. I would say sometimes most of the time they bring people here through cheap labor, and you find that the man from a Western country will get paid more than, you know. So yes, he will come here, he will find a job. And in some cases, let's say the Emirati man, the Arab man, marries a woman from Western world. This woman can actually also, with this woman, in most cases they will marry from any religion. The woman can be of any religion. I have never understood the reason why that is, because I don't know whether it is just their cultural religious view or what their religion requires, but the men can actually marry a Christian or whichever religion. Just if they marry her, just know that the children will have to, if a woman has to be open to knowing that the children will have to actually become Muslims, because the children is gonna be raised Muslims. So if obviously you might decide that you don't want to become a Muslim, you want to get married, but you don't have to change your religion to marry this man. But in some cases they will tell you, okay, yeah, let's just get married, you don't have to cover, you don't have to do anything, you just be the way you are, but then after some time maybe they change, and they are like, you know, they start being, you know, being a bit of telling you what to do, what your dress and everything, and maybe asking you and forcing you into the religion, or telling you that you have to. Or maybe they married you when they were not very religious and they became religious. So it forces you to, it brings conflict if you are not actually even also following his religion. And also for raising children, just know that Arabs, the woman of the house, her job is to raise children, is to take care of them, to make sure the family is organized and to take care of the family. His job is to go look after the honey and the money, and to bring food on the table and to make the family comfortable. But your job as a woman is to make family is running smoothly. Finances you will get from him. You don't have to work in some cases, you know. In most cases, you know. And your job is to raise the children right, including teaching the children Islamic ways. You have to learn some Arabic, and you have to learn some fundamentals of Islam, because your children will have to be raised Muslims. It is what it is. If you don't like that, then I don't think there is a point of view. But if you are of even going into this with them, you personally don't have to be a Muslim, but you have to know something, because you cannot expect the Western woman cannot expect a man to come and help, like to raise. They don't really like, it's your job to raise the children and to bring the children the way they should go. In most cases, the men are like going about their business, working and bringing home money and all that. So it's your job. So yeah, and in some cases you find that if the Muslim woman is married to the Western man, you'd find that she will get more support. Let's say there was a mishap in the family, in a sense of maybe the husband misbehaved and there was quarrels, and maybe you ran to your in-laws to go and resort, like to fix this, to help maybe become mediator. They might not actually the in-laws of the western men will actually really give you support, give the Arab woman much support, and actually even condemn the man for his actions. But in most cases in the Arab world, you will find that it will be most things that a man does
probably is going to be pinned on you. It's going to be your fault why he behaved the way he behaved. So you might find that the in-laws are not going to give you as much support. It is your fault that your family is breaking. Fix it, you know, fix it. Become a woman enough, become a wife enough, become a better wife. You know, some people are actually even going to blame you for things that are happening that are even not, some of them might not even be your fault. And you are going to be blamed, and you are going to go to the in-laws and they will be like, go back to your house and fix your house. Fix it, girl. Like, don't be coming here. You know, our son is this and good and da-da-da and da-da-da. It's your fault, you know. So, yeah. And also when it comes to the Arab woman going to the Western world with a man to go and find jobs, sometimes some of these women are very, very, very reserved. And they cover. They are very religiously, some of them are quite religious, and no, not some, but most of them are quite religious. They cover in most cases, and you might find that in the Western world, they might find it difficult to find jobs because in some countries, they don't even hire people who cover, like they still discriminate against women covering in the workplace. They have their own mode of dressing that they want to follow. So in some cases, you might find that even maybe the office space is quite open, and you might find that he works with even men, you know, and everything, and she's gonna be uncomfortable because in her culture or in her religion, she's not supposed to be like in a very close proximity with a man, because that's just how it is. She's a married woman and she's not, you know, and in most cases, it's not gonna be easy for her to find a job in the outside world, you know. And sometimes maybe in most cases when a woman is marrying an Arab woman is marrying a Western man, she is very like fluent in English and she can actually communicate to the man and maybe too open in a way that she's very open in that way to even think about, or even maybe she studied abroad to even think about even marrying a Western man. So yeah, she will actually speak English. That's not going to be a problem for her to find a job because of language barrier, but just the culture and maybe the her religion, and maybe, you know, the fact that she cannot just uncover herself and not dress according to her religion because of her job, she might not be able to actually, you know, find work because of the Western rules of dressing code and whatever, and sometimes getting discriminated. I don't want to repeat this, but you might find that it's gonna be a challenge. So in most cases, she will be a housewife. So, and you know, in some cases, the Western men are not used to, some of them are not used to women just becoming housewives. They are used to, you know, both are working and both are bringing money. But when you have children, you know, I think you will have to actually decide who stays home and who goes to work and things like that. So yeah, I think that's something that they have to actually bear in mind. You know, and what else? And also when the Western woman comes here and marries an Emirati, you might find that again, there is something that, you know, bilingual, the children are gonna be bilingual and maybe they're gonna be put in British schools, American school or whatever schools, but just know that religious education is a must to these children. And they have to learn Arabic. They have to, you know, they have to speak Arabic. And in most cases, they want to learn Arabic and the father wants them to speak Arabic and maybe speak with them Arabic. And sometimes, you know, them being bilingual might actually confuse children a little bit because you want them speaking English, the father wants them speaking Arabic, the family want them, you know, and it's gonna be a bit of tough. But the children who are mixed, the Arab mixed children, mixed Westerners and Arab, I don't think they have much problem in, you know, being discriminated or anything like that, because, you know, it's open like that in this place. If the family accepts a Western woman in the family, it accepts them. Oh my God, today I can't speak. And something else that you need to know is that the Arabs, they are very, very, very close with each other, with their family, you know. They are very, like they are very open and close with their family members. They like family outings, they like sitting, eating together, tea, shisha, they like family gatherings every Fridays and you know, every Saturdays, whenever it's a weekend, they always have picnics. They have like that family spirit of unity, you know. And in most cases, you might find that if a Western woman is married to an Arab man, she might find that, you know, in some cases, you know, Western people are not so open like that, in a sense of, you might find that even phone calls, it takes them ages to call each other, their family members. They don't even call. Sometimes they call once a year on Christmas, or if there is a special occasion, they don't care, you know, they don't have to like call and talk to them every day or whatever. But for the Arab family, they really have to talk to each other, and the phone calls are so unexpected. They can come even in the middle of the night, anytime. And your husband, whatever you're married to, if you're married to an Arab, of course he will have to pick up these phone calls, and you will not have to have a say about it, because it's a family member. This is just how they are. You have to accept their culture. Yes, there will be a random phone calls, wee hours of the night, wee hours of the time. And then again, sometimes in the Western culture, you find that nobody just shows up. Like, people respect timings and family. They want to, the family want their own time. In the Arab culture, this doesn't apply. People come in and go whenever they want. Families come in and, you know, they stay. You find that your husband's brother, friends come in, you know, even he stays until 1 a.m., 2 a.m. They are shisha and coffee and tea and dates. They are talking non-stop and laughing. Yes, you have family time, but at the end of the day, you have to know that their families are very, and friends, they are very close, and they are very important to them. And at some times, in most occasions, you might find that when people have family gatherings, there's a lot of women to women, there's a lot of touchy, and so, oh, happy tea, how have you been? Oh, bless your heart, oh, do, 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 do. You know, and you as a Western woman, you're like, oh, that's a bit too much, too kissy-kissy in the forehead and touchy-touchy. This is not what you're used to. No, you have to understand that this is their culture, this is their terms of endearment, this is the way they show their affection, this is the way they are, you know. And in most cases, I'm sure if a family accepts you as a Western woman to come and get married to their family, I'm sure you are welcome, and they accept you the way you are. They think that you should actually just accept them as well the way they are, and not be worried, or not be, you know, like be uncomfortable with in social situations with them. You have to accept them, and you have to be actually somebody who is very open in these kind of social situations, and very culturally aware, that you don't become uncomfortable and grumpy and rada, your husband is spending too much time with his friends and no time for you, rada. You have to also find time for yourself and with your friends as well, because your man is gonna spend time with his friends anytime, anyhow you want, and you don't have to say anything about it, because just that's just the culture. And I know people usually say that Arab men respect their women like you know, like, yeah, like they don't respect women, they don't have any disregard for women, but you know, that is just misconception. Me, I'm sure that there are some Arab men who are actually really honestly good to their women, and they don't mistreat their women whatsoever. I know that the rumors have gone everywhere in the world that they treat women like second class citizens, that women has nothing, not allowed to drive even in Saudi Arabia or in whatever. But I feel like it actually just depends, and it varies. Not all of them are like this with their women. Some of them really like respect and value their women a lot, you know. And their women says goes. What their women say is they actually listen to their women. And what else did I want to talk about? Yeah, there is a topic again when it comes to sex, because I saw in this blog that the woman who wrote this article was like, there was actually arguing that Arab men are not good in bed, that the only sex that if you are a woman who, you have to know that in most cases, their women are very closed, you know, like they are very, what can I say, they are very conservative, and they don't go, it's against their religious teachings, and it's against their law for a woman to go sleeping with different a woman can be divorced, that's a different case, and remarry, that's a different case. But when a woman is never married or is, you know, you are supposed to be a virgin. That is just the way it is. Like, you are supposed to be found virgin. And I know that maybe there are some women who are not, and they go to the doctors to stitch them back in place so that when they go get married on their first night, there's blood in the bed sheets. But at the end of the day, they just want their women virgin. And so if a woman, this woman in the article, there was an argument that if a woman has never had any sex in her life, and this is the only sex she has ever known with an Arab man, she will obviously feel like this is the best sex she's ever had because she's never had sex anywhere else. But if you are, if she was arguing that if that is the best, that is the only sex you've ever had, it will be the best sex you had. But if you have had sex, you know, you will not find this as the best sex. Her reason was that because according to their religion, and if they're very like religious, the only position that they are allowed to do is a missionary position. It doesn't go beyond that. The rest of the things are haram. Haram, kater. You don't go there, you know? So they believe that only Sharmudas are prostitutes, and people who are promiscuous and people who are this and that, those are the only people who go with this random bed position and these random styles. Where do they do that at? Like, it's not allowed. Only missionary position. Missionary position, or there's no sex at all that is going to be happening in that house. So if you are somebody who have been practicing randomly and doing all the random things sexually, everything, you might find this a bit. So the woman was like arguing like this, that they cannot satisfy a woman in bed. But then the women who are married to Arab men differed. Some of them say that it depends with your man. In some cases, sex is between the two people and you have positions and whatever is comfortable for you. And maybe it will disregard this position because maybe if he married to a very open-minded woman, this man knows what positions are there in the world. These men watch pornography. Some of these men are very open-minded sexually, because remember that when their women are covering and not having sex, they've been having sex all over the place, which for me, I feel it's unfair to start with. Because if the same religious book tells them not to have sex before they are married, how is it that the woman has to be a virgin? The man doesn't have to be. Like, they are just be going doing it, because the woman cannot prove if he's a virgin or not, you know? So they take advantage of this, yet the book has prohibited them. I feel like this is double standard. But at the end of the day, this man knows what to do. They know what position they do. The only time they refuse to do it is when they are married to a girl who they want, don't want this girl to snitch at them with their parents and say, oh my God, he's asking me to do this and that, and like, I don't want to be with him, you know? Because this girl will be like, oh, why are you asking me to do this? Where you learned this from? What have you been watching? Who have you been? So when they are with these Western women, they are very open to it. Like, you will find, and these women were saying that it depends with which man you marry. Sex is an understanding thing. Both of you understand each other sexually, and you know what is good for each one of you. You actually don't leave the bedroom until both of you are actually satisfied in it, and you are sure that your husband, your wife is sexually satisfied. That is the only time you leave that room. And that those women, some women were differing, and you know, in most cases, the woman was doing this, a lot of women, this article, a lot of women actually differed, and a lot of women were like, no, we are married to this man, we know what happens. So anyway, guys, I hope I attempted this topic well. And if you have any other topics that you can suggest to me, what topics you want me to make in this channel, and I will definitely do it. I always tell you guys to actually give me suggestions, but nobody ever gives suggestion. Give me suggestions. I'm gonna do it, really. And you guys, please, if it is your first time watching my videos, please don't leave until you subscribe. It is helping a lot, because
We plan to do amazing things in this video, in this channel, with the money that we get, the proceeds that comes from YouTube. Actually, I use them to fund orphan children back in Kenya, and the money is going to help towards educating an orphan child, a less fortunate child. So by subscribing, by liking, and even by, you know, doing, you know, commenting, interacting, you know, you are helping in this, you know, do something that is good to our child. So guys, thank you so much for hanging out with me. Oh my God, my room is so hot. My AC is actually broken. Thank you for hanging out with me. I hope to see you in my next video. Have a lovely day. Bye.